It has been revealed that a caucus, they want Ramaphosa to remove Minister of Education, which is Gwarube, over the Bella Bill boycott. So if you don't know what happened, is that the Minister of Education, who is from the DA, boycotted the Bella Bill, the signing of the Bella Bill, by not being present, despite the fact that the Bella Bill directly affects her department, but she did not show up. On the other news, the DA released a statement today, the 16th of September 2024. Tshwane is action as a final betrayal. Right, that's the letter or the news that was DA. So what they are saying is that Mashaba has turned Action SA into a useful idiot of anti-constitutional forces in South African policies, and in the process has jeopardized the future of the capital city. Did I just say that? Yes. She, according to DA, she has jeopardized the future of the capital city. On the other news, it has been said, Minister of Education, Sivuwe Gwarube, says she is looking forward to the discussion on the two contagious clauses of the Basic Education Laws Amendment, Bella Bill. Focus should be in the implementation of the Bella Bill clauses signed into law, says Gwarube. The very same Gwarube, by the way, who boycotted that. So, yeah. And on the other news, yay, there's something that is currently happening in this country. I don't know if you guys are noticing that. People are getting arrested left, right, and center. But this time, you remember that police got arrested in Beitbridge, if I'm not mistaken. This time, in Mpumalanga, traffic officials were arrested for fraud and corruption. Okay? So there's this thing that is currently happening where we're now seeing people that ordinarily were never going to be arrested, we suddenly see them getting arrested. So yeah, it is this and more that I want us to talk about in this episode. But before we can successfully do so, I am very much interested that people, you know, we've been together, man. So I would have loved if you guys were to do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people, because to subscribe it is free, to like the video it is free, to comment in the comment section below it is free of charge, to click the notification bell it is free of charge, to share this video it is free of charge, to watch this video until the end it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying, will bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Let us start with the traffic officials that got arrested. As it was reported by Chakaranda News, they released an article today, 16th of September 2024, by Mapabalo Oboroto. It says 14 officials, including traffic officers and driving school operators, were arrested for fraud and corruption on Monday. The article continues to say the arrests were linked to irregular issuing of driver's licenses and bribery. In 2021, an investigation was launched following allegation that a driving school owner in Sabi colluded with the departmental official in issuing learners licenses and driver's licenses to applicants without being tested after paying exorbitant amount of cash. I will simply say it's not a new thing. Yeah, we see that people are getting arrested, but I'm just saying it's not a new thing. It has been happening. People know that it has been happening for a very, very long time. But they continue to say, Spokesperson for the Road Traffic Management Corporation, Simon Zwane, has urged members of the public not to engage in bribery. The arrest following an extensive investigation involving RTMC Anti-Corruption Unit, the Hawks, and the Crime Intelligence. The suspects are expected to face charges of fraud, corruption, contravention of the National Road Traffic Act. Members of the public who obtain licenses through corrupt means pose a danger to motorists, and members of public are encouraged to desist from these corrupt activities. Let's all concur that the statement that says people who doesn't know how to drive, really, people who busy buying licenses, okay, some of them know how to drive, but they don't know how to follow the rules, which is still leads to this thing that people don't know how to drive. You see, I see a lot of these things in freeway, and I always ask myself, you know, people are very arrogant in their wrongness. So, for instance, do you know that in Joburg, for instance, we have got the worst drivers ever. People in Joburg don't know how to drive. So when you drive around freeways, the first sign that people don't know how to drive, they don't know what is written in K53. It's even somewhere on a freeway. What makes you see a person driving, and then they want to jump straight into the first line, and then they stick there. The law, the reason we've got many accidents, including the accident that I was involved in, it is simply because of a person who chose to drive on the fast lane. Then I'm not going to go into details as to how the accident occurred, but listen to this one. According to K53 in South Africa, you must keep left and pass right. That means you cannot expect people now to overtake you on the left, because left is more like a blind spot, more like a weak spot to South African drivers, because when we drive, we are sitting on the right. Therefore, we protect our weakness. How do you protect your weakness is that you must always stick to the lane, the left lane, allowing people to overtake you on your right, so that when you want to overtake as well, you also use your strength, which is the right-hand side. That's why on freeway it is written, keep left, pass right. It means overtake using the right hand lane, but then go back to the left. But people, what they do, they go to the right, allowing people to overtake them on the left. And that's why we've got so many accidents. Now let's move to this one. Caucus wants Minister Kwarube to be removed. It has also been reported by the very same publication, Lesecha Makura, on this one. Congress of the African Student, COSAS, wants Cyril Ramaphosa to remove Basic Education Minister Siviwe Kwarube. The call comes after Kwarube boycotted signing into law of the Basic Education Law Amendment Bill on Friday. Ramaphosa signed the contentious bill into public ceremony at the Union Building. Kwarube is a member of the Democratic Alliance, which has been vocal in opposing to the act in its current form. The bill proposes to give principal heads of department more control over schools' language and admission policies, removing some decision-making powers from school governing bodies. Also indicate that grade R will be the new compulsory school starting grade, and parents who fail to enroll their children for grade R will be formally penalized. Ramaphosa did, however, delay the implementation of the two provisions related to the language and admission policies, which causes upheaval among political parties, by 3 months for further consultation. COSAS president Sako Mahladisa said they believe Kwarube's anti-progressive behavior should not be tolerated. As COSAS, we want immediate resolved that she must be retreated as a virus in the basic education sector, and she must leave necessary, because this bella bill is too pr- progressive, that now we are in a government of national unity, which we believe should be inclusive. A bill that reflects of equal education, compulsory, universal, quality education should be provided. Why is she the one boycotting the signing of the bill? Okay. We'll talk about that. We'll talk about that right now. I don't know if I'm still trying to understand. Maybe I will be in her defense. I don't know, but angaz. Yes, you can remove her, but you see, the thing is that the GNU itself was formed on wrong foundations. There was never a mutual grounds between the parties. There was never a reconciliation between the parties. But now you want to create a unity. So I think that I will think that this is a result of that. Let's go to the DA. The DA has got this to say. Weeks ago, Herman Mashaba made it clear that Action SA will vote to bring down the Tshwane multi-party coalition. The decision by the party's Senate is a confirmation of what already been decided. Despite overwhelming opposition to this move, including by members of Action SA, Mashaba seems intends to bring down effective, well-functioning coalition that has achieved many significant improvement in the city financial audit outcome, incredible plan to secure maximum energy independence. They name them. To show the hypocrisy, they have taken credit for many of these achievements, and their councillors continue to serve in key mayoral committee positions despite Mashaba's pronouncement. More have signed petition against Action SA in the past 2 weeks than voted for the party in 2024 general election. The party's conduct towards coalition members, supporters, and public have been characterized by lies, deceit, and betrayal. The thing is, I would have entertained all of this, but it comes from a DA. A DA that is first to complain when they are fed their own pill, their own medicine. They are the very first people to complain. Which makes me ask myself a question. Wait a minute. When we talk about a DA and we want to talk about truth, betrayal, deceits, I don't think we can disassociate a DA with that. So I'm surprised they even have the audacity to tell us about people who are of that nature, because we haven't forgotten that they themselves couldn't even rebuke their own people when there was this issue of these farmers or those farmers who killed people and fed their bodies to pigs. We have not forgotten that the DA has never said anything. So we are aware that the DA have not said anything. I'm surprised that the DA knows the word hypocrisy. I'm surprised that they even understand the definition of hypocrisy. I don't even know whether I should even believe that the DA have got a definition of hypocrisy. I don't even believe that they... It's very funny. Yeah, it's very funny hearing it from ETA, who went into a collusion with the ANC and then come out of the ANC and backstab the ANC and badmouth the ANC. Do you want me to continue to name it, just to name the few? I wouldn't, but you already know. We've done that in this YouTube channel. So, kind of like DA telling me this, wanting me to believe this. I'll never believe it, especially coming from DA. Nah, fam. Nah, and this. But yeah, let's talk about the Minister of Education, for instance. I honestly believe that the Minister of Education showed us that, you know what, we don't care about this Ramaphosa that you guys fear. We don't fear him. And do you think that Ramaphosa is going to fire them I honestly don't believe so. As Khosa's once, but I just don't believe it, right? As for the Bella Bill, guys, I'm still studying the Bella Bill myself. I am very keen to understand what the Bella Bill is all about. Yes, I've been getting glimpses and highlights of what the Bella Bill is all about, but really, guys, I've never studied the Bella Bill. So to someone who knows it a bit better, please share, right? With that being said, I'll see you guys on the next episode. But until such a time, please take care.